Oh, hello there. Hello, please take a seat. Greetings, and welcome to our spectacular journey in our studies of authors and death. I'm your host, Anthony, and this is my assistant, Vector. Today, we'll be learning a little bit more on our topic, John Dyke. But first, let's ask Vector, who is John Dyke?
Hey, Vector. I have a question. Who's John Updike?
John Lawyer Updike was an American novelist, poet, short story writer, art critic, and literary critic.
John Updike was an interesting fella. He was a single child to Linda Grace and Wesley Updike. Linda was a writer and Wesley was a mathematician. As a young toddler, John was inspired by his mother's work. His first job was a copy boy at Sherrington High School. While John was a student at Harvard, Willow as Child was his first novel he ever worked on. Unfortunately, that was never published. He later had an interest in drawing and fine arts at Oxford, England, where he found and married Mary E. Pennington, having Elizabeth as their first daughter. Many of his works and novels, short stories, poems, criticism, were published in the New Yorker. The Carpet and Hen and Other Tame Creatures was one of his most compiled series of his poetry, reflecting to modern life. Here's an example titled, Why is the Telephone Wires Dipped and the Poles Are Cracked and Crooked? The old man say, the young man in gray, hung this thread across our plains, acres and acres we go. But the enlightened know, in point of fact that it's what remains of the flight of Marvis Crow, no one saw each ball crawl. In this poem, John talks about how telephone poles are related to those that are passed away yet remaining in presence of how many telephone poles that are still there. They are remembered, they're not forgotten. The Poorhouse Fair was his first published novel from 1958. In this novel, the theme is based on religious reflections and political aspects of moral beliefs in the setting of an arts and crafts fair between elderly seniors who hold wise principles against the teacher, Connor, who is main character. Now, one of John's most famous fiction novel, 1960, Rabbit Run, which exceeded the other series such as Rabbit Redux, Rabbit at Rest, Rabbit Remembered. Here is the summarization of Rabbit Run. Please follow along. Rabbit Run is about love affairs, sex, pregnancies from the same daddy, secrets revealed, and horrific tragedies. The setting takes place at Mount Jones, Pennsylvania. The main character, 26-year-old Harry, nicknamed Rabbit, who is married to Janice that's 8 months pregnant, finds out that their son Nelson took off drinking again, using the family's car. After having an awful argument about Nelson's bad habits, Harry ends up leaving the house, meets his basketball coach, Marty, who introduces him to his female friend, Ruth, which is highly experienced in sex. Rabbit eventually drops the car back to Mount Judge and bumps into the church, Minister Jack, who tries to convince him to stay with Janice. However, due to Jack's out-of-control behavior, Jack flirts with the minister's wife, Lucy, as he heads out with Ruth, heating things up in the suburbs. More drama spurs as Rabbit develops deeper sexual relationships with Ruth, soon finding out that Ruth has been seeing her ex, Ronnie. Rabbit becomes furious with his hard temper as he discovers Ruth, who gave her ex a blowjob. In the meantime, Rabbit gets an urgent call from the church minister, Jack, who tells Rabbit Janice is in labor. As Rabbit rushes back to see Janice, the two lovebirds finally come to their agreement, where Ruth gives Rabbit a blowjob as an apology. After the birth of the newly born baby girl, Rebecca, Harry tries to fix his temptations and tries living a happy life with his family and leaves Ruth. Sure, that didn't last long, as Harry isn't satisfied with his sex life with Janice's birth recovery. Harry attends the church to try and fix his moral behavior, so hoping that would solve his problems. Things turn around as he finds himself flirting with the minister's wife, Lucy. During the heat of moment, Harry controls himself, but ends up going back home, trying to convince Janice to have sex with him, but refuses. As the baby crying, frustrated and furious, he tries to force Janice alcohol. Luckily, Janice has the strength to say no and leaves. Ironically, Janice eventually becomes drunk as she starts drinking from the drama and accidentally slaps Nelson from her hasty rubbish. Even more horrid events start to string thanks to Janice's drunk unconsciousness as Janice accidentally drowns Rebecca during a bath. Overhearing the accident from Jack, Harry ditches the family and spends the night alone at a motel trying to reconsider the accident by Janice, with the guilt takes over as he influences himself through the fault of not being around the family from preventing the disaster. Finally, during the burial service, as Harry and Janice are in moments of sobbing, Harry becomes extremely paranoid and obliterates Janice's implication as he runs away like a rabbit. Harry ends up going to Ruth with a surprise. Ruth is now pregnant. Ruth then threatens Harry she won't tell about the pregnancy if Harry files with a divorce from Janice. In spite of quick thinking, Harry agrees, but once more escapes from Ruth, this time for good. Next, we'll talk about critique and author opinions. Here we have an interview with John with the New York Times. He explains a moment mentioned about the craft of fiction and the art of writing.
Myself as writing stylishly. I think of myself as trying to write with precision about what my mind's eye conjures up. So if out of this the sentences become shapely and vivid, that's great, but I'm really mostly concerned with trying to deliver to the reader my images and my sense of human behavior and of.
He writes with precision with his point of view from imagination, trying to send his view on visual human behavior and to readers of human nature of sight, smell, touch, hearing, and taste. Characters he developed with such personality, for example, as Harry in the Rabbit Run. The idea was for readers to feel the living up to the edge against all odds.
Everything holding you back and run. He was a runner. He had a moment of grace when he was a star athlete, and he's trying to recover that, so he's really on a kind of a quest. Anyway, it's kind of natural, I think, for a writer to be try to make the characters think things and do things that he diminishes. I don't think we ever valorized any life stage beyond youth in this country. So we're all failed youths. That is, we were best then. Life was had more savor then. We were more glamorous then. All ages ago. We don't believe, I think, in this is very full of generalizations, but we don't believe in the wisdom of the aged. They don't have a village wise man, you know? And especially now that so many people live forever.
Well, there you have it, folks. John Updike. Good guy. Made many, many, many novels, poems, and short stories. I'm Anthony Footit. I got places to go and people to see. Until next time, hey Vector, you ready?